Hi guys, welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to be doing just a little accessory to the car. I'm going to be putting this carpet as a liner in the trunk so I could put my tools, put my usually my mountain bike. So I put a lot of dirt, muddy, a lot of times put it in, tools, vacuum, ladders, the whole nine yards. So this carpet, I've used it in, I had it for a set for my Jeep. But like I mentioned before in my other videos that, I got total loss last month. So I had to go out and buy, this car right here. So this particular carpet, it's very good quality. It looks nice. Almost looks like, the ones when you do audio and video, which I used to do before. And then it has the rubber bottom. So it's, look, I'm pulling it and it's there's nothing on it. And it's hard to move it. I've tried the one that doesn't have the rubber in the bottom. Oh, and you just, that thing just, any little wind, it would just take the whole thing. So what I did with the Jeep was I cut it, I custom cut it. These things are about between $4 to $5 a foot by whatever width you want. I think it's, I don't remember if it's like 10 feet. It comes in that big roll at Home Depot. I don't remember if it's this way or that way, but it's a fantastic option. Doesn't cost you a whole lot. You could, use it in a trunk. You could use it in a, pretty much, an old car. I had an old 280ZX with the carpet in the back was already pretty much, the color, the dye had gone from the sun. And I cut this piece. It actually shrunk. I cut this piece. I made it a little bit bigger, had to make some adjustments. And it looked brand new. It looked great. I didn't have to go to an upholstery company, order some carpet, like 1,000 feet. So it's perfect. And like I said, if you spill a little something on it, it'll hold it. It won't go through it right away. Not like 2 gallons of water or something like that. But if you spill some paint or something, it gives you nice time to, take all your tools out and take it out and dump it, throw it out and get another one. It's not like the rubber that you buy custom made and then you put it in the trunk and cost a lot more. And then you can wash it, which is, pretty cool. So, but this, you could even use it as your regular carpets in the front if you want to cut them out, because they don't slip. They're really, really good about that. So in the Jeep, the way I had it was, I had it going on the sides too, about this height. In this case, I'm going to make a little hole and probably put like a little rubber band or something, because in the Jeep I had put like double-sided tape, a little Velcro, and it kind of sucked after a while. It didn't work that good. So what I'm going to try to do this time, it's use these little things here. I think it's for a little stupid net, because unfortunately this carpet, man, this thing, everything slips on this thing. So I put my groceries and things, and it immediately just, everything just comes out and then it falls back here. You open the door, everything's out. So I have an idea of perhaps leaving it a little bit longer, so once I clip it here, it kind of stays like this, so things don't fall back. So even if I open the door, at least I'll leave it maybe like a couple inches, and then I'll unlatch it from there and spill it over here, because sometimes I go get grass. I mean, I put everything in my SUV. I go get grass, because I do landscaping. I mean, I do pretty much everything. We get trees, anything. So then that way I could, when I'm gonna bring something in, I could like overlap it so it won't scratch it, like, see, like these things here. So we'll see. Let me see first how it works out, and we'll take it from there. And I'll customize it so it kind of like overlaps the seats. So when you do the seats, the bike, like my bike, the tire goes on that seat over there. Not this one, but this one. So I might just kind of like do like a little, UE thing. I'm not really sure. I'm going to first cut it out and see where it takes me. So every car is different. Every car, that's what I like about it. You can customize it if you want just the bottom part and don't want to do the sides. That's fine too. It's up to you, however you want to do it. But I think it's well worth it. I love it. It's good quality. And all right, let's get to it, because I'm actually going to use my bike today. And the other day I used it, and as you can see, there's some tire marks over there, and I already cleaned the sides. It was full of dirt, so I'm going to go ahead and try to put it in so I can keep the car as clean as possible. All right, so I got more or less the length that I want now. I know this car's big. You could literally sleep back here. It's huge. I remember when I had the old Escalade 07, I had an accident on my bike. We literally stuck two bikes inside the old one, which is probably about the same, you know, real estate. It's pretty crazy in here. So, all right, so this is what I was thinking, you know, like to let it overlap. So when I go buy stuff, I could just let it kind of fall this way, you know, instead of like falling all in there. Let me see how I'm going to play. But at least I'm going to let it cover like that worst scenario. And then, so the width of it has to be a little bit wider than that. So if you stand it up on the sides, see, look, even pulling it is hard on top of the carpet. So you want it to at least cover this. And if you want to leave it to do this, you could do a little slot right here. Let me see here, like I did it in the Jeep. Into a little slot. And then this thing will be higher, so that way it covers your doors if anything falls on it. So you could do different ways depending how crazy you want to get to it, you know. Same as here. So do you want it on the sides or do you want it flush? So if you want it flush on the corner, then you need to make that one a little wider. So then you have to cut this and let the carpet be a little bit wider that way, if you want it completely flat. So it all depends, like I say, you know, which way you want, you know, if you want it nice and flush like this, you know. See, if you want it nice and flush, you gotta, depending on the car you have, you gotta make sure that you measure the carpet from that edge to that edge, side to side, the width of the seats. So if you like it like that and it's nice and clean because you want to access all this stuff, you know, fine. That's, you can do it whichever way makes you happy. So I gotta think about this one for a second. Yeah, I might want to get at least the edges, bring it up to here, and bring it up to here so I have access to the switches. And then when you're not using it, you could always use these two seats, fold the carpet this way. That's why I will put a little slot on that, and you could use it like that too. So when I have people come in right away, I'll tell them, hey, you know, push the seat back and throw the carpet this way. That's why I usually put a little slot on that corner over there. So that's the way I normally like to do it. But all right, so here we go. I'm going to do a little brainstorming at the same time. Check out the time lapse. And once it's done, but you see, it's actually a little darker than the original one. If you see from here, I don't know if you can see it or not. If you can see it, it's a little darker, but it goes very good with the black, you know, with the sides. So I like it. So, you know, all these little knickknacks, all little things that get in your carpet, which are like so hard to take out, especially like a Christmas tree. Holy crap. If you put a Christmas tree in your car and you try to take out those little things, you'll be vacuuming it for a year. It won't come out. It's absolutely ridiculous. But, you know, next time I go get a Christmas tree, I'm just going to get like an old bed sheet, bring it in and do it. I'm not going to, because then it looks, even though it's for work, it still looks terrible. I still want it to look a little nice, you know. So, you know, in a couple of years, whatever, I'll throw it out and get a new one. All right, so let's get to it. It might seem like it's a lot of work, but if you go get one of those rubber ones, I don't even know how much it costs for this car, because I think it's different. You know, they might have one for the floors. I'm not really sure if they make it, you know, a full size. But I mean, it can't be any less than $100. So. But I'll check it out. I'll look for it and see if it's worth doing the hard work or not. All right, so look at this thing. almost like all you need is a little disco ball up there, and we're gonna do a little dance floor. Thing is huge. All right, so look at this thing. It's stuck on there, you know, to the edge. I did this little thing behind the seatbelt, very simple. So you cut it out like that. You can see it like that. And then, you know, you use a seatbelt, at least in this car, and you put it behind it. So you got the cut behind this, you don't see it. So it almost looks like, hey, you know, it's a professional job. So same thing here. So the seatbelt will keep it always pushed back. So, and then in the front, I'm using the little latches over here. So I made a nice little curve here. Make sure this edge doesn't hit your door panels if you have an SUV like this one, because it'll give you it'll kind of like put a little indentation on it. So make sure you close the doors. And it's just a little overlaps or something. Sometimes I put the ladder and it'll, you know, go over so something falls, doesn't mess up your carpet, doesn't stick to your carpet. So I'm using here the little seatbelt things to hold it. But maybe, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna do the seatbelt itself to hold the carpet back there. But let me see here. Yeah, I mean, this is not, as long as it stays on the wall, you're good. Same thing as over there. Use a little seatbelt latch that, you know, I basically don't use, so. All right, so pretty much, I'm almost done. Just gotta figure out the back here, what I'm gonna do. If I'm just gonna let it fall over this section here, and then shit will always fall into this thing, into these little metal things. So that way, so when I go get groceries, I'll hook it, like I said before, right here, put a little hook or something. Gotta figure that out. Maybe a little rubber band or something. You know, tie it to here. Yeah, that's probably what I'll probably do. Or, let me put some thought into that. All right, let's keep on doing it. Alright guys, this is the finished product. This little section didn't come out perfect, but once the door closes, kind of pushes it and the carpet doesn't come out. I was gonna do it with like a little curvy thing and put the hole on it, but since there are different levels, it's just carpet's a little bit, you know, tight. So as long as it all goes in and it doesn't get caught on your rubber piece, your seal, you're fine. Door closes beautiful, you know. So if I need to like drill, you know, drag something here, I could drag it. What I might do is I'll have an extra piece maybe like laying around here or like under it, like under here. So you see, this is what happens when you drag stuff on it, on these little corners, and tomorrow you go sell the car, it looks like shit. So it looks pretty nice. The seatbelt's keeping it all together there, nice and straight. I was gonna do a little angle cut over there, but you know, want to protect the edge of the cup holder, because if not, then they looks all scratched up when you put boxes in here and all that stuff. So I mean, it doesn't matter, this is just to protect, and it doesn't look so bad either. It looks like a nice, almost like a bed of a pickup truck actually. Yeah, pretty much. And that's it, man. You know, just cut the rubber under it, protects it, you know. So you could pretty much customize your, you know, your SUV whichever way you want to. If you want to do the size, if you want to do just the bottom, it's up to you. It's whatever makes you happy. You know, if you have a pet, you know, look how smooth it is. There's actually that hole in the middle because it's got the captain chairs, so obviously you're not gonna step on there, but you know, at least it'll keep everything nice and level. I could have cut it out if I wanted to, but it's fine like that. That way, when I stick the bike in there, the tire will overlap in the center, and then it will just, dirt will fall in there, as you know, as you're driving, as you hit the ditches and stuff like that. So you know, the dirt will come loose from the tires, so that way everything is protected, you know. So I think it looks pretty decent. I think I spent like $24 on this whole thing. it's, you know, more time consuming to cut it and make it pretty. So remember, if you're gonna put it on the sides, measure an extra foot here, an extra foot here, and then the length, and make sure it's as wide as the front seat. If you're gonna make it flat and you're not gonna use the sides, do the measurement on the widest section you want to cover. So if it's the seats over there, they're usually wider than the inner part of this, depending on the SUV that you have, and as far as you want it to go. So if you want it actually to actually go up like that against the seats to protect the seats, then you will need another like foot and a half or so, and then you could always cut it. It's better to be able to cut it than not have the extra length that you need. And then you could decide, you know, I don't want it like that, then I'll just cut it. But then if you already put it in and then you want it, you say, hey, that crazy guy had a good idea, you know, like make it go behind the seats. So things don't, you know, because I used to, you know, you hit brakes sometimes, you know, somebody cuts you off and then something flies and hits your seat. You know, those are leather and plastic, and they get all scratched up, which actually happened in my Jeep a couple of times. I had tools in it. They ran, you know, hit forward and they scratched the back of the seat. So, you know, this one's big enough to actually fit all my ladders and stuff like that. So here we go. All right, guys, thanks for watching. If, you know, subscribe to the channel. I got a bunch of cool stuff coming on the Escalade, things around the house, you know. Also check out my mountain bike channel. I do mountain biking. We do also maintenance in the park, which is pretty cool. Real estate, flips, things like that. So thanks. All right.